Now, globally, climate change is causing glaciers to shrink. But Pakistan's Shisper Glacier is expanding, causing tons of ice and debris to roll down the valley's rivers. Villages downstream are threatened. As water swells in the rivers, locals begin fearing for their homes and animals. We tell you more in this report about the climate danger that faces Pakistan.
This is the Indian Army's high-altitude warfare school located in North Kashmir's Baramulla district. The place where soldiers are taught to how to deal with adverse weather and avalanches while guarding the nation's fences during a six-month-long course. The school is more than 70 years old, and every year, hundreds of soldiers are brought here, trained, and later deployed in places like Siachen, the highest battlefield in the world. With the break of dawn, they get ready to learn the art of ski patrolling and other important techniques which are essential at the time of natural calamities. Men from the Air Force, the Central Armed Police Force, are also taught here. The institute is considered among the best in the world.
In high-altitude warfare school, we are trained on how to identify the avalanche-prone slopes, and then we are taught how to cross them. There are a lot of aspects which are covered, and then we are also taught that what all we have to do if we are caught in an avalanche. And lastly, we are also taught that if one of our comrades gets struck in an avalanche, then how we have to evacuate.
The snow is around 7 feet high, and temperatures are hovering around minus 10 degrees Celsius. These trainees have to start by acclimatizing to the low oxygen level at 11,000 feet above sea level. Dressed in black, these teams of rescuers from the halls are kept ready and alert 24/7. There are seven such teams who at one phone call are ready to dispatch anywhere when avalanches hit frontier posts along the line of control between India and Pakistan. A team of specialized doctors are also kept alert all the time.
We also have the avalanche rescue teams, which as of now, as I stand here, our teams are ready. One team is already employed, and other teams are ready to be employed. And these teams are specialized teams. They are able to operate in very steep gradient slopes. They have those got the equipment to detect the bodies, etc., which are deep embedded inside the snow.
The school has trained soldiers from several countries, including United States and France. The experts from Hawes are often called by Western countries to exchange ideas on how to deal with avalanches. Recently, its men saved lives of several soldiers buried under an avalanche.
We follow the two basic rules of avalanche rescue drills. One is with avalanche rod and one is with AVD, avalanche victim detector. In case the casualty is not carrying any avalanche victim detector, we have to use avalanche rod. That was the case in the last avalanche rescue mission that we had carried out. We used the avalanche rod in a steep gradient of slope, and in runout zone we were able to recover the three bodies of a jawan.
One of its kind school where they are trained, prepared how to deal not only with the avalanches but also to prepare for the warfare in the cold and adverse conditions, both in Siachen and also in the Kashmir region where terrains are very difficult and temperatures can dip to minus 30 degrees Celsius. We have seen several avalanches hitting Kashmir Valley from the past some years, and recently several dozens of lives of soldiers have been lost not only in Siachen but also in the Kashmir Valley itself. Now the army says they are trying to bring more modernized equipments, including detectors of the bodies and other things, but the weather conditions right now where I am are hovering around minus 10 degrees Celsius, and despite those odds, these tests are being conducted of these jawans who come to here and train as soldiers and later are deployed not only on the fences but also in Siachen and other places across India. With camera person Feroz Ishanwani for WION World is One.